Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I really had no idea what I was going to film, and I definitely didn't want to use neutral colors because I know I use a lot of neutrals. It's kind of like that's my comfort zone. I think that I still stayed in the neutral family, kind of, without really being neutral. I used a lot of peachy shades, pink shades, and I just kind of, I don't know, came up with this look. Also, a lot of you guys have been asking how I do this top knot on Instagram, and I almost feel ridiculous doing a whole video on it because it's so simple. Maybe I should just do it right now. All right, I grab all my hair, usually standing, flip my head over, and put it up where I want it. Kind of get all these baby hairs because they're out of control. And then I just kind of do one twist, and then I wrap it around without twisting the rest of it. And that's it. And then I put it in the hair tie. I have these hairs that will fall out, so I bobby pin them, and then I'll just play with this and kind of bobby pin it. All these hairs that come out because I have layers. I need bobby pins. Makeup tutorial, hair tutorial in one. Swing. All right, guys, so first things first, you want to apply a base to your eyelids all the way up to the brow bone just to make our eyeshadows appear more vibrant, and this is MAC Soft Ochre. Now I'm going in with Beaches and Cream, and this is by Makeup Geek, and I'm going to pack this onto the lid all the way up to the brow bone with a Sigma shader brush. Next, I'm going into the Anastasia Lavish palette, and I'm going to take Orange Soda, one of my favorite transition colors, and I'm just going to loosely put this into the crease just to give us kind of a roadmap of where we're going to be applying eyeshadows, and it's also going to help our other eyeshadows blend really nice and give us a good gradient. Next, I'm picking up Red Brick, and this is a shadow by MAC, and I'm going to use the same 217 brush for this. I'm going to apply this directly into the crease, and I'm going to focus most of the color in the center of the crease because I'm going to be applying this eyeshadow by Saucebox called LULU. It's a really pretty hot pink shade, and I'm using the same brush for this. I'm going to apply it to the outer corners and the inner corners of the crease, kind of creating a spotlight for that orange shadow. Now take a really loose fluffy brush, this is a MAC 224, and just make sure that you have all those edges blended out really nicely. Now I'm going to take Peach Smoothie, this is another eyeshadow by Makeup Geek. If you guys haven't tried their eyeshadows, they're so nice, very comparable to MAC shadows, so I love using their products, just because they're more affordable. I'm packing this just onto the lid. This is one of my favorite highlight colors. It's Nylon by MAC, and I'm just gonna apply this into the tear duct area. And then whatever's left over on my brush after I'm done with this step, I'm just gonna run that on the high points of my brow bone. And that's just gonna catch the light really nicely right there. So now it's time for the eyeliner. I definitely didn't want to use black, so I thought gold would complement the peach shades so much nicer. This is NYX Glitter Liner in the color Crystal Gold, and I'm just going to apply this just like I would a normal liquid liner. Before I finish off the lower lash line, I'm going to apply my concealer, and this is NARS Creamy Concealer in the color Custard. And the reason I do this is just so that I don't make a blunt edge by applying the concealer after I've already blended the shadows on the lash line. And this brush I'm using is from Walmart. I'm not sure what it's called, but a lot of you guys ask me. This is Cosmopolitan by Makeup Geek, and I'm gonna run this along the lower lash line. Then I'm gonna blend it out. And to tie in the crease, I'm applying more of that Saucebox eyeshadow just to the outer part of my lower lash line. So now that we're done with the shadows, it's time to apply false lashes. These are my absolute favorite. They are House of Lashes in the style Iconic. And just look how fluttery they look. I love them. I always get so many compliments on these lashes. I usually don't like to apply too much mascara to them, but I'm applying a little bit to the base just to kind of stick my natural lashes to my false lashes. So now it's time to finish off the skin. I'm using my Sigma F80 flat top kabuki brush, and I'm buffing in my Benefit Hello Flawless foundation. I love this foundation because it's really dewy, makes you glow. And I'm going to take Bare Minerals Concealer, and this is in the color Well Rested. I'm going to use this to actually brighten my under eyes, and you can see the difference right there. And you guys always ask me about this brush. It's from Walmart. It has no name. I'm sorry. Now, I'm clearly excited about this bronzer. I don't know why I stopped using it or never started. I don't know. I've had it for a while, but it's MAC Give Me Sun. And I'm applying this with the same brush I've been using for my bronzer, which is the Sigma F40 brush. Now, to deepen my contour, I'm going into the contour palette by Anastasia Beverly Hills, and I'm just gonna apply that right there in the hollows of your cheekbones, and this brush is by Bellamy. Now I'm taking MAC's Whisper of Guilt, and I'm putting that on the top of my cheekbones and also my Cupid's bow. And I'm sorry that this product is limited edition. I have recently been on a mission to find a new highlighter, and I think maybe I have, so I am going to film a video with it. Very excited. Sticking with the peach theme, I'm gonna use MAC Peaches Blush and apply that right behind the apples of the cheeks. This lipstick is definitely on my top lipsticks for summer, and it's called Summer by Melt Cosmetics. I'm applying that directly from the tube, and I love this because it's matte, and I'm loving dewy skin with matte lips this summer. So that completes the look.
I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time. Bye!